Hey folks, welcome back to Fisher Shop. Have you ever wondered if those diode laser engraver machines are more than just a cool gadget for some makers? Well, you're not alone. I've ventured deep into the world of diode lasers. I've actually owned 7 of them over the last couple years. Now, my earliest machines are pretty much only good for engraving a logo or some text onto some work pieces, but you've got machines coming out now that are very, very capable, feature-rich machines. And in this video, I'm going to show you how these lasers aren't just a purchase, but they can be a potential income stream. We're going to explore how you can turn your diode laser into a profitable side hustle. Let's get into it. Now, many of you, particularly entrepreneurs, might be familiar with the ideology of the triple constraint. Simply put, this means that your customers are looking for products that are cheap, can be provided fast, and are good in quality. Well, you can't have all three. Instead, the theory states that your customers can pick, well, just 2 of them. If they want it cheap and fast, then it's not going to be as good as it can be. If they want it fast and good, then it's not going to be cheap. And finally, if they want it cheap and good, well, then it's going to take a little time to deliver. Well, as someone looking to make money with a diode laser, you can strategically pick out a machine that's going to do well in each one of those areas so that you can provide products cheap, fast, and good. This is the IKIER K1 Pro Max. It's a 48-watt diode laser, and I chose this one because it's packed with all kinds of features that help me do my engravings and my cuttings fast and accurately. Now, really, there's just 2 things that you can do with a laser. You can either do engravings, or you can cut. Now, you can definitely add all kinds of value to just about any item by personalizing it with an engraving. I found that I can sell a laser engraved face grain cutting board for the same price that a more complicated end grain cutting board would go for. I visited several local realtors in my area and I struck up a deal where they purchase cutting boards from me and I laser engrave their client's name on the front and then the realtor's info on the back. Then they give these boards to the new homeowners as a closing gift. The homeowners love it because it's got their name on it, and they typically prop it up somewhere in the kitchen as a statement piece. And the realtors love it because when the friends come over and visit and they say, "Whoa, where'd you get that cutting board with your name on it?" They flip it over and they say, "Well, from my realtor." So it's great marketing for them. Another option is if you can get your hands on discarded barrel heads, you can use your laser to turn them into signs. They don't even have to be authentic barrel heads. For example, I made this fake one out of some oak butcher block that used to be a tabletop, but it turned out fantastic. And I sold this to someone that needed it as a wedding gift. And here's some piggy banks that I designed, which I engraved the child's name on. Not only are they pretty boxes, but with the personalized engraving, they're going to be used as a showpiece for quite some time. Now, many of you know that I make and sell my own table saw push sticks on my website. Well, I use my laser to engrave my logo on every single one. And when I accidentally bump the laser and I mess it all up, I still make money because I sell it as a joke. Actually, my screw-ups sell better than the perfect ones. Here, I made some trophies for 1st, 2nd, and 3rd place shooters at a sporting clay event. They wanted something that had a graphic, so I purchased that image off of the web. I threw down a piece of cherry, and I let the laser do its thing. Afterwards, I just trimmed the board to its final dimensions, I gave the piece a good sanding, and I applied some finish. And there you go. 3 award plaques that were simple to make. Another way to make some good money is to get a rotary for your laser. This essentially replaces the y-axis of your laser with a device that will rotate a cylindrical object. Once you have this hooked up, you can engrave all sorts of round objects. Vases, cups, bottles, wine glasses, all can get lasered on a rotary. But if you ask me, the real moneymaker is making custom tumblers. See, you can purchase blank tumblers in bulk for pretty cheap online and then usually sell them for 3, maybe 4 times as much once you've personalized them with a graphic or a logo. You can sell these for corporate events or retreats or outings or sports teams. And these are great because really you only have to do the computer work for one because all the rest of them are exactly the same. Now, all these examples have involved using the laser for engraving. Well, the other thing that the laser can do is cutting. So when would you want to cut something? Well, I use it all the time when I'm doing sign making. I'll cut each of the letters out with the laser, I'll paint them whatever color the customer wants, and then glue them down onto a backer board. This works out great when making signs, or when your son wants to dress up as a vending machine for Halloween. Besides, cutting pieces out with a laser can be really, really satisfying. Other things I make are seasonal items, such as Christmas ornaments. I pick up small sheets of 1/8 inch plywood online that come in packs like this. These work wonderfully on the laser and they cut so nicely, allowing for all kinds of detail in these ornaments. I just purchase the design files off Etsy, bring them into the Lightburn software, and I hit go. A few minutes later, they're ready for a little sanding, and then they're done. Another seasonal project I enjoy doing is making little lanterns for Halloween. These sell like crazy in my area, and they're super easy to make. I make them out of cedar fence pickets, and for each picket that I buy, I can get about 2 lanterns made. The fence pickets are $3.50 a piece, so even if I sell the lanterns for cheap, like $15 a piece, I'm still pulling in over $26 in profit for every 2. These things are a lot of fun to make, and I've had to make multiple trips back to the lumber store to get more material because I keep selling out. I'm telling you, the laser is a very versatile tool. Sometimes I use both engraving and cutting. The next example is going to paint me as the gigantic nerd that I am, but I actually designed and made an entire board game using the laser. Each piece was engraved and then cut so that they'll all fit together. Even all the little ships and the player boards were made with the laser. Now, I'm yet to make any money with this, though. I mean, the only thing I've made are enemies because I seem to win every time, but who knows? Maybe I'll end up selling the idea to a gaming company and I'll become a zillionaire. Now, as for other types of materials you can cut and engrave, well, there's a lot. For instance, you can use a diode laser on leather. Although it stinks worse than a port-a-john at Lollapalooza, but it does work, and you can make some really cool patches or burn something inspirational onto your son's baseball mitt. Slate stone will also take an engraving. You can get blank slate coasters for cheap online and then personalize them and then double or triple their value. You can really personalize just about anything with a laser. I remember when I first got my machine, I was walking around the house looking for things to engrave, and it was a blast. It's one of those things that once you understand how the machine works, all the different ideas and all the possibilities, they just start come flooding in, and you really understand just what an awesome tool this is. Now, many laser manufacturers offer optional accessories for the machines too, and it makes them even more versatile, or it adds a feature that wasn't available with the stock configuration. For example, some offer longer rails. This lets you just about double the length of your current machine so that you could do some huge engraving jobs. And to make it easier and quicker to use, you could get a camera for it. This allows you to take a picture of your workpiece and have that imported as the background of your design software. Now you can place your text or drop your graphic right onto the work area and see exactly where it's going to be engraved and how it's going to look before you even hit go. And for those of you who would like to set up your laser indoors, you can either build your own or purchase an enclosure for your machine. Now, some of the nice ones have windows so that you can see what's going on, they're lit up with LEDs, and they have an exhaust fan and tubing so that you can route the smoke out your window, across your lawn, and into your neighbor's house. So now, you can run your laser inside. You won't have to shut down your production during the winter months because it's just too cold out in the garage or in your workshop. So where do you get started? Well, first, you're going to need a machine. Now, if you're curious about the laser that I chose, I'll have a link down in the video description to the exact laser that I'm using. Or you could just go over to IKIER.com and take a look at the different lasers that they have to offer, as well as all the different accessories that they have available. Next, you'll probably want to set up a storefront on a platform like Etsy to sell your products. Be aware though, the internet, it's starting to get pretty saturated with folks trying to sell their laser engraved products, so you might have better luck actually focusing locally. I primarily use Facebook Marketplace to sell most of my items, and that way I don't have to mess with shipping and potentially damaged items. But any way you go, be prepared to strike out a couple times before you find something that really works well. And when you do find something that's selling really good, that's when owning a diode laser can be a lot of fun. Hey, I hope you enjoyed the video and that it was helpful to you. If it was, drop me a like and a comment down below. And if you're brand new to the channel and you feel I've earned it, consider subscribing. I'd love to have you on board. Thanks so much to IKIER for sponsoring the video and for making an amazing machine. Well, that's going to wrap this one up. Thanks so much for watching. Take care, and we'll see you next time. Have you ever wondered if those... Wow. I, myself, am pretty stupid. Onto some little... Bleh. Engravings, or you can cut with it. Now many of you know that I make and sell my own table saw push sticks on my website. Well, I use my laser to engrave my logo on every single one.
That was a good one.
Done. I'm done.